The lab is something that in 2014 we started. Mm-hmm. I teamed up with the instructor and asked them to lend me the gallery space for 2 weeks in July. And then for every day of those 2 weeks, I invite a different creative to come in and to do a project. And this project can be something experimental. It can be a project that maybe they've had that they've not actualized in a physical space and want to see how it looks. Okay. Right? So basically, it's just an opportunity for us to experiment. But the most important part of the lab is that we need to realize, as consumers of art and also as producers of art, that this culture that we have, we need to be urgent. Mm-hmm. I can't say I'm going to the art show afterwards or in a couple of weeks. I need to show up now. And also, as creatives, we're always complaining that we don't have enough spaces, we don't have enough events. We need to make these events happen, right? So for the 2 weeks, we have events mm-hmm. every day, except the 19th. And somebody, we have actually two of the artists here, so you could, four of the artists here, so you could talk to them about their work, right?
Oh, yeah,
that would be good, so that you could get them to come. But basically what this is Grub, and I have a little, I could email that to you. Yeah. I wrote a little text about it. Mm. But basically what Grub is a response to people's hyper-monitoring of my weight. I don't know if when you saw for Panic, I did a scale, mm-hmm. and on the scale there was a quartz clockwork that moved. Mm-hmm. There's a plain bathroom scale with a quartz clockwork. It's called Weight Watcher. Mm-hmm. Because they constantly, and this is something that I've lived some entire experience from a kid, you monitor how much you eat and what you weigh, and you know, I've always been bigger than my little cousins. So there was that. Come high school, I decided, you know what, I want to be attractive to these boys, you know, you come into yourself as a teenager. So starvation, not anorexia, I can't say that because I've never been diagnosed, but starvation was a big thing. And the most beautiful thing happened, out of a very unhealthy space. I lost all the weight, but I also lost all the monitors. Oh, yeah, where do you eat that? What should I eat that? And blah, blah, blah. So Grub Picks is that. It's poetry, photography, installation. You know, to bring the food conversation to the table, because everybody eats. Some people eat too much, some people eat too little. Mm-hmm. But we know that these have physical consequences, like you can see it on the body. And even though we live in a culture that's constantly at one side they're constantly bombarding us with food, and on the other side they're constantly bombarding us with what society deems a perfect body, which is completely out of sync. You know?
Mm. You can't generalize that means that you have to be more than the wrong way and do a lot of work.
So that's what you have here.
Okay, so I'm not going to ask about your name, but I will ask, what do you consider to be healthy?
What do I consider to be healthy?
Healthy, in terms of body size and shape, without going on one end to fat and without going on the other end of being extremely, because you would be surprised that some of the biggest people in the world are also some of the healthiest people in the world. Mm-hmm. Because they eat certain things and don't eat other things.
Yes.
And reverse some of the skinniest people in the world, body size, are actually binging and purging and that kind of thing. I'll let you answer once the camera person arrives. So.
Okay, well, I've answered that for you now. For me, what is healthy is realizing that you have to be confident in your own body shape. No two bodies are alike. Mm-hmm. You know, and I find that the most unhealthy thing is this, like I said, hyper monitoring of what society says is a perfect body, with the same time bombarding us with food. And most of the time it's not the healthy food, it's not like, they don't bombard you with lettuce and eggplants
and
you know, healthy grains, whole grains. Usually they bombard you with some fast food, you know, some kind of dessert. And then the next thing, desserts. You know, as a little kid, I remember at birthday parties, my uncles would tell me, yeah, I'm sure you should eat a cake. Why not? Because I didn't trouble what I didn't have no cake. So there's this whole thing about Also, what to eat. There's this book by Roxanne Gay that's called Hunger, where she says that America hates fat people. And that the bigger you get, the smaller your world becomes. She says she goes to grocery stores and they take food out of her cart. Literally, just random strangers. Or people take food out of her cart. And then people come to her, they come to her book signings, and while she's signing to so and so, oh, I have this nice diet that you should try. And I don't know if men have to deal with that, but I do know that women are bombarded by how their body is supposed to look. I'm not saying men don't have to suffer that. But I find that it's very, very prevalent as far as women. We have to be constantly concerned about what is the perfect image. You know,
and
what the perfect size.
Do you find that it's easier to ignore at this point? Or are you in some ways because of this exhibit still tied to the whole idea of what makes the perfect body?
I'm so amazed by it because I ignore it, but literally as I'm crossing, the other day I was going to HRCU, and as I cross, this lady tells me, get out of that foot! First of all, I don't know who she is. Right? I didn't recognize her at first, so I didn't respond, and then I crossed. So when I crossed, she said again, get out of that foot! So I didn't respond again because I'm still trying to register who this person is. So then she asked me, said, you know my mom, you don't know who me? And then it hits me. But what I'm saying is that unsolicited, I'm not very familiar with this woman. She's a friend of mine, but at the same time, they just feel like they have a familiar one. And my size, and how I look, you know? So, 2020.
Unfortunately, I honestly, I don't get that, and I suppose this is the biggest I've been, but it's never really been a big deal for me.
Okay.
It really has. Obviously, I know I have to stop some weight in order to. It would be supported for health reasons, not so much because I'm afraid of being large. If you will. But, if you're ready.
But you know what's so amazing about that? There's this entire body positivity movement that is happening all over
the place. That's the other thing I was about to ask you.
All sizes, but especially what they call obese, morbidly obese, and overweight women are deciding, you know what, my body is okay as is. But
doesn't mean you can't diet, doesn't mean you can't.
No, but that
acceptance,
that's such a big thing. Because I think a lot of times when it comes to being overweight, people are quick to tell you about the health. They're quick to tell you about, oh, you know, you need to be healthy. But they don't talk about the mental and emotional health that comes along with that. You know what I mean? You could constantly just be telling people, but you have to accept yourself first. Like even before you start a diet or before you start an exercise regime, you need to accept yourself that this is not me. And like you said, what I'm doing is for my health. It's not to fit in. But I find the conversation is not about people being healthy. It's just that you're unsightly to me and I want to lose weight. I mean, people have told me that. Yeah, I can't believe you don't ruin your body. I'm still able to walk and I'm still able to do all the things, you know, that I used to do.
But
things
have not changed just because there's more of you, if you will.
But
I'm using
their response.
You get the point.
Their response to me has changed because when I